always been fascinated by African-American artists just because I'm always curious how other artists represent the Black experience through their medium, especially like visual art. There's still this idea of celebration of history, celebration of like heroes and leaders and things like that. There's still the idea of this militant attitude, you know, that I think that some of these paintings are, that might be inspired by the Black Panther Party. It's like not too dissimilar from like Kendrick Lamar as far as like that attitude and that edge, you know? Yeah, it just shows like how much of this conversation is still ongoing. There's a lot more art here, I feel, that's showing how painful that period was. Period in the 60s and during the civil rights era was a lot more painful maybe than, or slightly more painful than it is now, because it's still pretty painful sometimes. But I think that it's interesting to see how there's still those parallels for sure. I think one of the things that was always lacking in music education, especially jazz education, is like the context that it was created in, like the time period, what these people were going through, why they were creating the kind of music they were creating. And so it's really cool to be able to put these two things together because it helps make that context. It's my first time at the Broad, which I'm ashamed to say, but it was a pretty special way to see it for the first time. And yeah, I can't wait to come back. It was really cool to see not only how this exhibit has been curated, but just how the space feels and how it's all been shaped. So yeah, it was a pretty amazing experience.